artist talking
with Guitar Guitar.
Hey guys, Alex Hutchings here, and we're hanging out at GUITARGUITAR Edinburgh, and we're hanging out with the guys from Laney. We're going to have a good time this evening, but just quickly, I thought we'd spend a minute talking about something that I think is really important, and that's just timing and time feel. And, you know, over the years I've practiced with metronome a great deal, or drum machines, or whatever backings on a keyboard where you press stop start and it's like, do-do-do-do-do, you know. Anything where there's solid time, and I also like using loop pedals. They're really interactive and a good way to kind of test your timing. So I just thought I'd show you a few ways that I use looping. All right, so I've got a basic clean sign here, and yeah, let's just loop up something short and succinct, like two bars or something, three, four. So, you know, that's a really instant way of just kind of testing your timing, but also feeling, you know, it's all about feeling it internally, you know, and I think the more you work with a metronome, hopefully it kind of trains that internal clock, as people call it. And this is super important when you come to jam with others as well, you know, if you're playing with a really sick drummer, he's like, "Gats!" You know, you should be feeling the same time, you know, so that's really cool. Let's try another one. So that was just like a kind of an A minor vibe, and I was, I guess, just practicing my pentatonic stuff. Let's see. I'll tell you what, this time let's try and do an overdub as well. Have a bit of fun with it. Do there. Now, actually, I was pretty dissatisfied with that because I was just too busy thinking about some other stuff to kind of be exactly in the zone. But again, this is where you can get real time kind of engagement from using a loop. You know, it's one of those things that's pretty hard to do. When I'm you know, trying to help people out with loops, the key is to really try and keep things succinct and straight and count yourself in. So. That's super important, especially if you're going to be doing stuff with your foot. So 1, 2, 3, and ban up, 3, 4, keep it going, 2, 3, and ban up, and then doing the overdubs and all the rest of it. So yeah, like I say, using the loop is a good way of kind of interacting with your own timing and time feel. So try it out. You know, if you guys got a looper hanging around on your multi effects, or you've just got one that you've got in the cupboard, get it out and have fun with it. The other thing you can try is using a delay pedal. And I've got one here, which is really cool. It's called the Difference Engine. And I've been playing with that recently, which is kind of cool. And what I like to do is set the longest delay time, strike a note, and just with like two listens, see if I can kind of feel a tempo. It's kind of some sort of Victor Wooten shit, you know. I'm gonna give it a go. Let's see what happens. Okay, so I'm gonna strike a note, have one or two listens, and see if I can get a sense of time between the notes. Here we go. So yeah, there we go. Bit of fun with timing. Like I say, find your favorite delay pedal, mess with it, put it on the max setting and see what you can come up with. You know, you find yourself kind of weaving in and out of stuff. You know, there was a few times there where I went into like some sort of triplet idea. And then I was thinking in two bar phrases and stuff like that. So yeah, just enjoy it, have fun with it. Play with a metronome drum machine and then get out there and play with some other people. All right, all the best, see you later.